Good morning, Cresthill family. Today I want to try something a little different. We're not going to be throwing balls of string around, I promise that. Okay. I want everyone who's listening, whether you're here on campus, online, Roku TV, wherever you are, I want everyone who's listening to close your eyes. Now, I'm not going to shock you. I'm not going to come out there and do anything crazy. Just close your eyes. Let's enjoy being in the house of the Lord. With your eyes closed, take a deep breath in and then let it out slowly. With your eyes still closed, say with me, I am forgiven. I am forgiven. Again, I am forgiven. One more time. I am forgiven. And before you open your eyes, take another deep breath in, letting it out slowly. Okay, open your eyes. Isn't that refreshing? Don't you feel a little better? Isn't it great to be forgiven knowing that your sins been washed clean? Amen. Amen. Because if you have confessed your sins and have repented, if you have asked God for forgiveness, if you have accepted Jesus Christ as your personal Savior, you are forgiven. It says so. Amen. Give God some praise. Because he even said so in 1 John 1:9, if we confess our sins, he is faithful and just and will forgive us our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Purify us, cleanse us, wash us clean from all unrighteousness. And again in Colossians 2:13 it says, when you were dead to your sins and in the uncircumcision of your flesh, God made you alive with Christ. He forgave us all our sins. The word is all, folks, not some, not a few, not the little ones, but the big ones, all of them. You have been washed clean. It's like when the teacher takes the eraser to the whiteboard. It's wiped clean. It's right there throughout the scripture. You are forgiven. But there's a problem with some people. And I had this problem for a while when I first came to Christ. You just can't stop dwelling on the past. You feel loaded down with a bucket full of guilt and shame, and you can't forgive yourselves. Day after day, week after week, we keep praying for forgiveness for the same sins that we have confessed over and over again. Sins that the Father has already forgiven us of. And I'll tell you a little secret. Sins that God does not remember once he forgives you. You have to stop dwelling in the past. God himself even said so. Isaiah chapter 43, verses 18, and again in verse 45, we read, listen to this. Isaiah 43, verse 18, forget the former things, do not dwell in the past. How much more clear does God have to make it? He's given you a command right there, don't dwell on the past, it's over. Verse 25, I am he who blots out your transgressions. He's talking about God. I am he who blots out your transgressions for my own sake and remembers your sin no more. There's a great song by Morgan Cryer. It's called, What Sin? Part of it says this, and I'm not going to sing it. I promise, man. I don't have that bucket to carry a tune in because, no. What sin? It happened so long ago. I cried out for mercy back then. I pled the blood of Jesus, begged him to forgive my sin. But I still can't forget it. It just won't go away. So I wept again. Lord, wash my sin. But this is all he'd say. What sin? What sin? that's as far away as the east is from the west. What sin? What sin? It was gone the very minute you confessed, buried in the sea of forgetfulness. So we go to God because we're loaded down. And we say, God, forgive me for this. And he's going, what are you talking about? I already forgave you. I don't know what you're talking about. I forgot all about that. It's almost confusing a little bit. Man, that is beautiful. God's even inspiring song to inspire us to move on. God has forgiven you and has forgotten the sins you have confessed and repented of. That's important. You repented of. Look at Psalm 103, verse 10. He does not treat us as our sins deserve, mercy, or repay us according to our iniquities, grace. For as high as the heavens are above the earth, so great is his love for those who fear him. And this is not a childhood fear where you're scared. This is a fear, an awe, that it's a love of God. As far as the east is from the west, so far has he removed our transgressions from us. East and the west will never meet. And that's how far he's removed it. There's a group called Philip, Greg, and Dean. And there was another group out there that did this song also. It's called Tell Your Heart to Beat Again. If you guys don't listen to Christian radio, especially 91.9, you gotta start listening, man. They're playing some great songs. And this is one of them. It's called Tell Your Heart to Beat Again. Part of it goes like this. Forgiven. If only you'd forgive yourself. You've been made new, but you're still standing where you fell. Because when you look in the mirror, it seems like all you ever see are the scars of every failure and the you you used to be. Not the you are now, the you used to be. That's not you anymore. The chorus is, tell your heart to beat again. Close your eyes and breathe it in. Let the shadows fall away. Step into the light of grace. I love this part. Yesterday's a closing door. You don't live there anymore. So say goodbye to where you've been and tell your heart to beat again. Yesterday is gone forever. Ladies and gentlemen, what you did yesterday, if you confessed and repented, it's like it never existed. You don't live there anymore. You sold that house and you moved on. That door is closed, locked, barricaded, and you cannot get back in. Amen. Praise God. Yes. Thank you, Father. There's even more scripture that confirms confessed sins are forgiven and forgotten. In Hebrews, we read, for I will forgive their wickedness and will remember their sins no more. Hebrews 10:17, then he, God, adds, their sins and lawless acts I will remember no more. I mean, how many times does God have to say it over and over and over again? And even again in Jeremiah, we find, the days are coming, declares the Lord, when I will make a new covenant. I will make a new covenant with the people of Israel and with the people of Judah. By the way, the new covenant is Jesus Christ himself. He is coming so that the old will pass away and the new is here. In verse 34, no longer will they teach their neighbor to say to one another, know the Lord, because they will know me. From the least of them to the greatest, declares the Lord, for I will forgive their wickedness and remember their sins no more. Over and over and over again and all throughout the scripture and even in song, God is inspiring artists to remind us and to tell us he has forgiven our sins that we confessed and repented of. We take a stand for Jesus. We ask for forgiveness. He forgives us. and then he remembers them no more. Ladies and gentlemen, we have confessed. He has forgiven, and I promise you, they will be remembered no more. In July 1519, the Spanish conquistador, Hernan Cortes, and his men took over Veracruz in Mexico. Cortes and his was a traveling conquistador, and he was conquering different areas. And once they took over Veracruz, Cortes said enough. To eliminate any idea of retreat and to inspire and motivate his men onward, Cortes burned his ships. Now here's 2, 3, 4 boatloads of conquistadors coming into Mexico from Spain. And I'm going to put some motivation in you to keep moving forward. I'm going to burn the ships so you can't retreat. You can't go back to where you came from because we don't live there anymore. The burning ships by Cortes reminded his men that they made a commitment for life and there is no turning back. There's no longer an escape route. There's no way out. We have to march on to victory. And the victory we're talking about is the victory that we have in Jesus Christ as our Savior. Amen. Amen. The expression burn the ships, and I think a lot of people have heard this, the expression burn the ships has come to mean eliminating all your options so that there is only one path forward. And we've got to stay steady on that path. We have to keep our eyes fixed on that path, and we have to keep moving forward. And as Christians, that's exactly what we need to do. We need to remind ourselves that we have made a commitment to follow Jesus Christ. There is no turning back, and we need to burn our ships. You guys hear King and Country? Ever hear that group, For King and Country? I love this group. My wife and I were able to attend a concert last year, and they are definitely a British group because they came out with all the costume and the regalia, and it's like, man, this is cool. They're great. And they've got a song called Burn the Ships. Man, God is inspiring us all over the place to keep moving. Don't dwell on the past. You're hurting yourself. You're loading yourself down with guilt and shame that doesn't even exist. Check this out. Step into a new day. We can rise up from the dust and walk away. We can dance upon the heartache. Yeah, we can dance. Yeah, I was a sinner. You know, sin stained me crimson. But I can confess and repent and ask for forgiveness on forgiveness. And I can dance on that heartache because that heartache doesn't exist anymore. So light a match, leave the past, burn the ships, and don't you look back. Hallelujah. What a great song. Later the song says, feel the weight disappear. We did that breathing exercise in the very beginning. Did you feel a little lighter when you were done? Feel the weight disappear. We're coming clear. We're born again. Our hopeful lungs can breathe again. Oh, we can breathe again. Praise God. That's some good music. Let's give God some praise for that music. Thank you, Father. Oh, hallelujah. So what you need to do now is breathe again. Oh, hallelujah. Let the breath of life fill your lungs. Breathe in, folks. That's the Holy Spirit. That's Jesus. That's God in this place, man. You're forgiven. I've got new life. I've been reborn. And I'm moving on because there's only one path forward. And by the way, leave your baggage on board that ship you're about to burn. Ain't no reason to be taking that baggage with you. You're better off without it. So you burn your ship, but leave your baggage behind. Our sins have been forgiven. We have been redeemed. We are fulfilled and we are completed in Jesus. Now stop dwelling on the past and start living a life filled with the Holy Spirit. Thank you.
Come on, that message is so, so powerful. It's an amazing message with practical tools. Right now in the chat, give somebody a high five. Don't click off. I know you might think that service is over, but it's not. We still have some amazing information to share with you. We have one question for you today. You just heard an amazing sermon. So what are you gonna do about it? The first step is to give your life to Christ. If you've never given your life to Christ, why not today? You don't get it by watching us. You don't get it by rules or rituals. You get it by having a personal, real relationship with Christ. If you want that today, pray this with me right now. Jesus, come into my heart. I receive you as my Lord and Savior. God, I give you my life. I give you total control of my life. I believe you are who you say you are, and I believe everything the Bible said you did. And I ask you to come into my life. I know that I'm a sinner, and I ask for forgiveness today. I want to trust to follow you as my Lord and Savior. In Jesus Christ's name we pray, amen. If you pray that with me right now, God just came into your heart to live inside of you. I want you to go right now to cresthill.org/connect. This is means for a party. This is means for a celebration. So tell us about your decision that you just made by going to cresthill.org/connect. Don't wait. Go to cresthill.org/connect. There you'll be directed to our church's website, and then you can just click the blue button that says connect. Fill out some information about yourself so that we can celebrate with you today about what you just did. Don't wait. Hit the blue button that says connect today. Also, if you say, hey, I know about Jesus, but I want to find a church home, you can be a part of Cresthill's fellowship wherever you are across the globe. So go to cresthill.org/connect to be a part of our Cresthill family today. So lastly, did you like what you saw today? Have you thought, I would love to spread the message of Jesus across the globe? Then go to cresthill.org/give to do just that. Help us spread the message of Jesus across the globe. God bless you. I also want to invite you to come next week. Matter of fact, don't just come by yourself. Have a watch party with your friends so that all of you can praise God together. Come along with Cresthill next week. We know that your time is precious, so we want to thank you so much for joining us today. We don't take it for granted. You could be doing so many other things this Sunday, but you decided to spend it with Cresthill, so we thank you. So lastly, we love you. God loves you. Never give up, never give in. And as always, keep the faith.